We would need to add 9, 36, 4, and 25 to complete each of these squares. Great thinking if you found these numbers. For the first polynomial, we can think about having one block that's area is x squared, and then 6 other tiles that have an area of x. We take the 6x and we split 3 of the x's over here and 3 of the x's over here. So we'll have x squared plus 6 x's, and then we'll need to add 9 1 pieces to complete our perfect square. So when thinking about completing the square, it's best if this b term is even. This allows us to split up the x's so we have half of them here and half of them here, and then we can figure out how many 1 pieces we would need to add to complete our perfect square down here. For this first polynomial, it turned out that was 9. For the second one, we draw a similar figure as the one before, and we'll find out that we'll need to add 36 1 tiles to complete the square. For this third polynomial, we said we had negative 4x here. So we'll have our x squared like before, and then we'll have negative 4 x's. So negative 2x and negative 2x, which makes negative 4x. So if we were to lay out these tiles, we could see that we would need to add 4 more 1 pieces to complete the square. We know that this diagram also makes sense in terms of multiplication. We know x times x equals x squared, and x times negative 1 equals negative x. We have this negative x 4 times. Once here, once here, once here, and once here. And finally, for these 4 1 pieces, we have a side length of negative 1 here, and a side length of negative 1 here. So negative 1 times negative 1 would equal a positive 1. We have this positive 1 4 times, so we know we have to add 4 1 tiles to complete our square.